Today I'd like to tie for you a peacock and GSS nymph. The hook I have in a vice is a 5262. This is too extra long, too extra heavy nymph hook from Green Caddis Outfitters, greencaddis.com. I have a 3mm brass bead on there, and I'm going to put a little extra weight of 20/1000 lead wire. I'm going to put the wire just on the thorax section. And we'll get about 10 wraps in there. We're going to push that up inside the bead and break off the remainder. I'm going to use olive thread, and this is Sivigny Denier. We're going to start the thread behind those lead wraps, and that will keep the lead wraps pushed up inside the bead. And we'll cover over the lead wraps and bring the thread back to where the thread would hang at the barb of the hook. Right there. Starting with the tail, I'm going to use an olive pheasant tail center. And I'm going to take 6 or 8 of these. Make sure that you get them lined up at the tip. And that tail we want to be about half the length of the shank. Now if you were tying a pheasant tail, you could just take this and wrap this for your pheasant tail body. And we're going to wrap that back, and that helps cover the lead wraps. Cut that off with the poking snip. Now for a rib, I have pearl tinsel, and this is 16, number 16. Nice skinny one. I'm going to tie that in. Now I'm going to take 2 strands of peacock herl, and I'm going to tie them in by the tip and break off the really fragile tip section. This helps you to get a little bit more color on there. And with most peacock herl, the fibers are larger on one side. You want to keep those larger fibers towards the bottom. Then when you wrap it, you'll have those larger fibers sticking up. Oop, let me back off on that. There we go, got them together pretty nicely. We're going to tie the thorax with this. And you can see we got a nice high body there. I gotta back that off, it separated on me. There we go. And then we'll bring that up to the thorax, and we'll tie that off. Hold them back, put a couple of wraps on top, and then you can just break them off. Now we're going to take that olive or that pearl tinsel, and I'm going to counter wrap it. And we're going to have just a rib going through, and it's going to look like a rib of peacock herl. And we're going to bring that right up to the top. I'm going to give it an extra wrap and tie that in. switch hands here while I, and then secure that tinsel. Now, if you've been tying long enough and using a lot of peacock curl, you get down to what is basically almost garbage, but all short pieces here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take these, all these short pieces, we're going to take a clump of them. We're going to take a clump of those short pieces, and I have about 8 or 10 of them here, and we're going to tie them in, and this is going to be our wing case. Bring that right back to that abdomen there. Now we're going to take our GSS olive. We're going to pinch off some, and we're going to dub that on. With the GSS material, it looks like it's a mess, but just twist it. You could even wet your fingers a little bit and twist it, twist it, twist it. It'll go on. You can take the top ones and fold them back. Take the bottom ones and fold them up. And you'll make a nice noodle. You just have to pinch off a clump from the pile. You don't want to pull out a bunch of strands. You want to pinch it off out of the bag. We're going to take this and wrap this. Up to the bead. Now we're going to take the peacock hurl and hold that over. Tie them in, pull them back, wrap a few wraps in front, and then we can cut these off close. Take our whip finish. Take our head cement. Put it on there. I put it on the bead and let it roll back. Not going to hurt the bead with a little bit of head cement. It won't detract from anything. Make sure our peacock curl is laid over there nicely on top. Now we can take something like our dubbing needle and just pull out a few of those GSS fibers. Kind of just break them right in the middle there. And you can kind of separate them there a little better. There we go, and when it's in the water, they should flow back nicely. And here we have a peacock GSS nymph. Hope that you learned something from this video. Hope you would subscribe to my channel. Please refer me to your friends. Leave comments, questions, suggestions, and most of all, thank you very much for watching my videos.